Assalamualaikum. Hi everyone. I am glad for having the opportunity to meet all of you again. Today, we are going to start a new chapter entitled Reactivity of Metals, Part 1. Minerals are substances formed naturally in the earth. Some are precious, such as gold and diamond, and some are more ordinary, such as quartz. They have a definite chemical compositions and crystalline structures. Various minerals are contained in rocks found in Earth's crust. There are over 3,000 minerals known. They can be found either in their pure form as the elements or chemically combined with other elements to make compounds. A compound is two or more elements chemically joined together. Minerals that are made up of elements are gold. Gold has been used as currency for centuries, and people buy gold balls used as safe asset. Iron is one of the first metals used to make keys, include machinery and tools, as well as vehicles, building, and aircraft. Silver is used to make jewelry and silver tableware because of its shiny appearance. And finally, magnesium. Magnesium ignites easily in air and burns with a bright light. It is used in flares, fireworks, and sparklers. Here are some examples of minerals that are made up of compounds. Quartz has pretty solid and durable material, thus making it ideal for creating the glass of watches. Hematite, which means blood red in Greek, could be crushed to a fine powder used as a paint or cosmetic. Bauxite contains aluminium, which has become a very important mineral because of its light weight. It is used in making utensils, electric wires, and also extensively in the packaging of food products. Calcite is used in modern construction in the form of limestone and marble to produce cement and concrete. Calcite is a compound which consists of three types of elements. There are calcium, oxygen, and carbon. The combination between calcium, oxygen, and carbon chemically will form calcite, or its scientific name is known as calcium carbonate. Bauxite is also a compound which is made up of two types of element, oxygen and aluminium. Oxygen and aluminium combine through a chemical reaction forming a bauxite, or its scientific name is aluminium oxide. Here are seven examples of compounds, their common and scientific names together with the combination of their own elements: hematite, quartz, bauxite, cassiterite, and calcite have oxygen as their elements respectively. When oxygen reacts with iron, iron trioxide will be produced. The combination between oxygen and silicon will result in the formation of silicon dioxide. The reaction between oxygen and aluminium will form aluminium oxide. The chemical reaction between oxygen and tin will produce tin 4 oxide. Finally, for calcite compound, the chemical reaction between calcium, carbon, and oxygen will result in the production of calcium carbonate. For pyrite and galena, they have sulfur as their elements. When sulfur reacts with iron, iron 2 sulfide will be produced. Meanwhile, the reaction between sulfur and lead will form lead 2 sulfide. This is a simple experiment to show that calcite or calcium carbonate is a combination of calcium, carbon, and oxygen. A spatula of calcium carbonate powder is put into a boiling tube. The apparatus is set up to test the property of the gas released when the powder is heated strongly by passing it through lime water as shown in this diagram. What is the expected result? Yes, the lime water turns cloudy because of the presence of carbon dioxide gas. Therefore, we can easily write the general chemical equation like this. Calcium carbonate that has been heated will produce calcium oxide and carbon dioxide.